Hi guys, so this is chapter 11 SPO15 deformation of solid. So kita ada 14 chapters, so kita dah tinggal lagi 3. Okay, so kita ada learning outcomes, kita ada 11.1 stress and strain. So ini boleh refer dekat you punya tutorial book juga. Okay, first kita akan cakap pasal stress. Stress simbol dia adalah sigma. So basically kita ada satu wire. Normally in chapter 11 we talk about wire. Okay, so stress is defined as ratio of force to the cross-sectional area. So because what we talk about wire, so A awak ni akan jadi pi r square. Okay, luas circle tu, cross-sectional area tu. Yeah, so apa yang jadi kalau stress ni lebih kurang dengan force lah. So bagi force, dia tu panjang. Bila nak panjang tu, dia stress. So dia lebih stress lah. Okay, then kita ada strain. Strain pula is defined as the ratio of extension to original length. So strain equals to E over L naught. So contohnya kita ada satu wire, then you exerted some forces. Macam ada getah kan, awak tarik. So this will be L naught, then you panjang sebanyak this one. So the differences between these two adalah E, elongation. Dia mesti pemanjangan, dia bukan pasal pengecutan, mesti panjang. So dia tak ada unit lah, sebab L minus L naught is meter, L naught is meter, dan dia gonna cancel out each other. Alright, so strain, this is strain lah. So kita ada stress and strain graph. So you can see that you mean y-axis is stress, x-axis is strain. So kita ada point A, B, C, D, E. So A ni adalah proportionality limit at this along A, O to A. The wire return to its original line when the force is removed. Maksudnya OA ni bila you remove force, dia akan kembali ke bentuk asal. So kenapa dia proportionality limit? Sebab OA ni, stress awak is directly proportional with strain. Strain naik, stress naik. Strain naik, stress naik. Macam tu. Okay. Dan AB ni pula, kalau tadi bila you bagi force, dia stress kan? Okay. Tapi AB ni basically dia macam extra sikit. You bagi force, dia terpanjang lebih. Kalau kita kata OA ni, kita bagi 1 newton force, dia panjang 1 cm. Tapi AB ni bila kita bagi 1 newton, mungkin dia panjang 2 meter. Contoh. Okay, B ni pula kita panggil sebagai elastic limit. So, OAB ni sepanjang perjalanan ni, dia will undergo elastic deformation. And some said that A ni, point A lebih kurang dengan point B. Lebih kurang sahaja. It depends on the type of material. Okay. So, B to C pula, the permanent has the material has permanent extension when the force is removed. So starting from B ni, BC ni dia dah start jadi permanent deformation dah. Okay, plastic deformation ataupun permanent extension. So kalau tadi panjang kita adalah OA, so sekarang ni wire awak dah permanent, tu tak boleh awak tarik getah kan, macam getah rambut kita, getah rambut perempuan lah selalunya. Okay, tarik, after sometimes bila kita pakai, dia akan nampak yang macam kawasan nipis-nipis tu. Kawasan nipis-nipis tu basically that is extension dia lah. Means that dia punya rubber band dah ada new length. So CT ni, OT ni, sorry, OT ni is an extension dia. Okay, so C ni pula adalah yield point. After point C, plastic deformation starts. Okay, bila plastic deformation ni, kalau tadi elastic dia kembali ke bentuk asal, kalau plastic dia dah tak kembali. And also, dia akan ada internal structure changes. Kenapa it's able to extend? Contohnya, kalau you ada, kita cakap pasal wire kan solid kan? Okay, ada arrangement macam ni. Oh kan power kimia. Ini kan solid punya state kan? Okay. Tapi, after sometimes, kalau elastic deformation, you tarik, dia akan kembali bentuk ni. Dia tarik ni. Tapi bila dah bagi sangat-sangat force, internal structure dia will be shifted. Kata dia macam ke kanan sikit. Dah distorted. So maksudnya bila dah distorted ni, internal structure dah berubah, we undergo plastic deformation. Okay. So D ni adalah tempat kita bagi maximum force. E ni kita dah bagi force sangat-sangat, lepas tu tali awak putus. Bila putus ataupun pecah tersebut is called as breaking point, material break or fractures. Ni or eh. Okay, so belakang depan ni elastic deformation, belakang adalah plastic Deformation. So ni adalah contoh. So ni are differences. Elastic, a deformation, wire able to return to its original line. Plastic does not return. The wire is permanent, lengthened. Okay, extension does not extend exceed elastic limit. So this one, extension exceed elastic limit. So elastic deformation, this one obey Hooke's law. This one does not obey. Elastic deformation does not change the internal structure. For this one, it change the internal structure. So, this one kena hafal lah, at least hafal 3. Senang, elastic kembali bentuk asal. Plastik tak. Yang ni obey Hooke's law, yang ni tak. Yang ni tak acid. Elastic limit, yang ni acid. Ha, macam tu je. Okay, ni contoh lah. Kita getah, kita tarik. Kembali bentuk asal. So, ni adalah elastic deformation. Okay, then kita ada stress strain graph for various material. So, you need to know yang ni lah term kita ada ductile and also brittle. Ductile ni mulut. Erti kata lain dia macam contohnya mulut tu boleh dibentuk. You panaskan. Contohnya you panaskan satu benda. Lepas tu dia cair. Lepas tu boleh bentuk. Awak pernah tengok kan? Yang dekat Mid Valley ada kedai tu yang dia buat apa? Gula-gula tu. Dia lenyek-lenyek gula makin panjang. Lepas tu putus. Tu mulut lah tu. Maksud kita boleh bentuk. Okay. Able to length greatly and undergo plastic deformation till it breaks. Okay, tapi brittle ni pula break after the elastic limit is reached. It does not undergo plastic deformation. Sampai limit pecah. Itu brittle. Contohnya glass lah. Therefore, kalau you tengok glass ni ada straight line je. Dia tak ada bengkok-bengkok. Sebab bengkok-bengkok ni represent plastic deformation. Kalau straight line ni is just elastic deformation. And also you can see kalau stress dengan strain ni, gradient dia sama dengan Young modulus. Okay. Tu saja 11.1.